الحمد لله رب العالمين، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. إلهي كفاني فخرا أن تكون لي ربا، وكفاني عزا أن أكون لك عبدا، ومما زادني شرفا وتيها وكدت بأخمصي أطر الثريا دخولي تحت قولك يا عبادي، وأن صيرت أحمد لي نبيا. فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. عباد الله، يقول الله تبارك وتعالى في محكم تنزيله: والعصر، إن الإنسان لفي خسر، إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. فأوصيكم وإياي بتقوى الله، اتقوا الله فقد فاز المتقون. أما بعد، respected brothers and sisters in Iman, we have praised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we should continue praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لأن الشكر لله وحده والثناء عليه فهو رب الناس جميعا والمخلوقات كلها. All praise are for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The عنوان or موضوع of our khutbah today is من أنصاري إلى الله. Who are my helpers for Allah? Who are my helpers to Allah? Who are my supporters for Allah? نداء من الله سبحانه وتعالى لعباده المؤمنين. It is a call. It is an opportunity which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving to all of us equally. ذكورا وإناثا. Men and women. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is inviting you. يقول في سورة الصف chapter 61 ayah number 14: يا أيها الذين آمنوا O you who have believed. كونوا أنصار الله. Be supporters of the deen of Allah. Allah is inviting you to be a helper, to be a supporter. نعم, to support the cause of Allah, to support the advancement of the deen of Allah, to support in Muslim community development. كونوا أنصار الله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is informing us of what happened in the past, in the time of Isa ibn Maryam. كما قال عيسى بن مريم للحواريين. As when Isa ibn Maryam said to his disciples, his students, his followers, من أنصاري إلى الله. Who amongst you are going to be my followers, my supporters? Who amongst you are going to extend the hand and the heart and the mind of help for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's cause? Man ansari ila Allah. Man ansari ila Allah. Who amongst us in this masjid is ready to support the cause of Allah? Who amongst us is ready to help the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Who amongst us? Man ansari ila Allah. قال الحواريون نحن God, the disciples of Isa ibn Maryam say, we are ready, we are the helpers in the sake of Allah, for the sake of Allah, we are helpers of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَآمَنَتْ طَائِفَةٌ مِّن بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ. The portion of Banu Israel believed and they followed Isa ibn Maryam and they supported the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But there was another portion, وَكَفَرَ الطَّائِفَ. But another portion rejected, denied. They refused to believe in Allah and to support the cause of Allah. Always, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that those who believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them upper hand. Allah gave them victory over those who rejected Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَكَفَرَ الطَّائِفَ فَأَيَّدْنَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا عَلَىٰ عَدُوِّهِمْ. We gave support. We supported and strengthened. We made victory those who believed in Allah and gave Nusra to Isa ibn Maryam over their enemies and they became victorious. Allah is inviting you. Do not wait until Yawmul Qiyamah, then you regret. Do not wait. Islam is not only for Sheikh and Imam and Da'iyah. Islam is deen of Allah and each one of us is expected to participate. Ahbab, there is a promise, wa'adun min Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala li'ibadihi alladhina nasaru deenahum fi hayatihim. There is a promise. Ma ahlam Allahu 'anna haythu amhalana wa qatama dayna fi dhunubi wa yasturuna. Allah is merciful. We sink in disobedience to Allah and sometimes we turn our backs to the deen of Allah and I gave khutbah some weeks back on ghafla. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is still merciful. He is giving us respite and time. لَعَلَّنَا نَتَذَكَّرْ أَوْ نَخْشَى. We may remember to come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or we may fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is promising. He says, وَلَا يَنْصُرَنَّ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَنْصُرُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَقَوِيٌّ عَزِيزٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that He will give victory, He will support, He will make victorious, He will make successful those who help His deen, those who support His cause, those who are ready to advance His cause. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that He will give them nusra. He will make them victorious and successful and strong in iman. He will cover them by His mercy and barakah. وَلَا يَنْصُرَنَّ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَنْصُرُ. مَنْ, there is condition here. We have to help the cause of Allah. We have to help the deen of Allah to earn the nusra from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we don't, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to give us nusra. Many people ask what has happened to the ummah. Everybody is talking like that. Na'am, because we have not volunteered, we have not sacrificed enough to serve the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to support the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَقَوِيٌّ عَزِيزٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is exalted in mighty, but also in power. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning a quality of people who deserves nusra, people who deserves victory, people who deserves stability and security, people who deserves rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and barakah. Al-ladina in makkannahum fil ard. Those who deserve victory and help and support from Allah are those when we establish them in the land with authority. Aqamu salah. The first thing they do is that they establish salah. Wa atau zakah. They do not promote shukun al buhlun. They are not stingy. They give. They help the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them. Wa the same time, they will always support the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by enjoining all that which is good, all that which has maslaha for the community and ummah. They will always enjoy it. They will always encourage it and support it. وَنَاهَوْ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. And they will always forbid any evil thing which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forbidden. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forbade, and that it has no maslaha for the ummah. وَلِلَّهِ عَقِبَةُ الْأُمُورِ. And only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, only Allah has the best end of all of things. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the determination of all affairs. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is inviting you and promising you at the same time that you have His support. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will support you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you His nusra. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring you more closer to Him. He will make you victorious above your enemies, on condition that you make at least one step ahead. A condition that you sacrifice to help the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ahbab Rasulillah, Allah does not need you and me to help His deen. Allah does not need you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhal nas, antumul fuqara'u ila Allah. O mankind, you are all poor, you are all bankrupt, you are all in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahu huwa al-ghaniyyul hamid. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the all-sufficient, all-rich, a possessor of everything, but also one of all praise. Allah does not need you to help His deen. When Abraha advanced with the intention of destroying Al-Kaaba, what happened to him? What happened to Abraha and his army, one of the greatest army of that time? Huge elephants advancing to destroy the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of Al-Kaaba. Abdul Muttalib came and told them, look, the best you can do is return my camels. And he advised Ahlul Makkah to go on the mountains. He told them, the Lord or the owner of Al-Kaaba will take care of it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يقول في القرآن ألم تر كيف فعل ربك بأصحاب الفيل ألم يجعل كيدهم في تضليل وأرسل عليهم طيرا طيرا أبابيل ترميهم بحجارة من سجيل فجعلهم كعصف مأكول. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not use any human being. He said birds. Allah does not need you. Do not think that you are favoring Islam. Do not think that you are favoring Allah. Allah does not need you. You need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is a mercy of Allah that He is giving you an opportunity to serve, to support the deen of Allah for your own benefit. Man amila salihan fali nafsi. Whosoever does good, he is only doing good for the benefit of himself. وَمَنْ أَسَاءَ فَعَلَيْهَا. Whosoever does evil, he is only harming himself. وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِالظَّلَّامِ لِلْعَبِيدِ. يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to wrong anyone an ox. Some of us were told, Ahbab, we need some donation. He thinks 10 times before he gives $10. Ahbab, we have this masjid, we need to occupy this masjid and fill it. Let me think if I can. Yani our work, we think the salah should revolve around our work. La, our work should revolve around the ibadah. Allah does not need you, you need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How do we claim that we love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam illam nansuruhu, if we do not support the cause of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving another promise. Allah is giving another promise, and He says, فالذين آمنوا به. This is سورة الأعراف chapter 7 verse 158. فالذين آمنوا به. So for those who believes in Rasulullah وعزروه and honor him. They honor Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم ونصروه and they support his cause. They support him. They help him. واتبعوا النور الذي أنزل معه and they follow the light with which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him. أولئك هم المفلحون. Those are the successful ones. It's not لسنا مجرد الكلام. It's not all about lip service. أحب رسول. ما الدليل على ذلك؟ What is the proof that you love Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم? How much have you sacrificed to help Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم? How much? بعضنا يقولون والله هذا الزمان زمن الفساد. You know this time is time of فساد. أتمنى لو عشت في المدينة مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. He say I wish if I lived in Medina with Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. والله maybe it is mercy for you that you are living here today. If it is just a lip service, but I love Rasul, if is loving Rasul is only Facebook, if loving Rasul is only social media, but you do not sacrifice to advance the cause of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you are not successful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يقول في سورة آل عمران قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله. Saying if you claim that you love Allah, then prove your claim by following Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you do that, يحببكم الله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love you. ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you your sins. يحببكم الله. Allah will love you. ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم. And Allah will forgive you your sins. والله غفور رحيم. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the oft-forgiving, most merciful. Those who believe in Rasul and honor him and help him, help Rasulullah, support the cause of Rasulullah, support ما جاء به Rasulullah من رب العالمين, you support it. وَاتَّبَعُوا النُّورَ الَّذِي أُنْزِلَ مَعَهُ and that they follow the light with which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down to Rasulullah, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. Those are the successful. Success in dunya, success in qabr, wa success in akhira. يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنٌ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Your wealth that keeps you away from helping the cause of Allah. Your children that occupies you. Your good job that keeps you away from helping the cause of Allah will not help you on the day of Qiyamah until and unless you appear in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with submissive heart. The heart which is clean, which believes in Allah, which followed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the heart which went extra mile to serve the deen and cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Man ansari ila Allah. Who are ready to support me to advance the cause of Allah? There is hadith in Sahih Muslim, and please listen to this hadith. Listen to this hadith. If you know it, it's a reminder. If you don't know it, inshallah, it's learning, it's teaching. If you knew it and you forgot it, at least remind yourself. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, radiallahu anhu, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The messenger of Allah, may peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, say, ما من نبي بعثه الله في أمة قبلي إلا كان له من أمته حواريون وأصحاب يأخذون بسنته ويقتلون بأمره. That whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent a prophet before me, any prophet who was sent before me, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, except he had amongst his community, amongst his nation, amongst his society, حواريون وأصحاب. He had disciples, but also he had companions around him. These disciples and companions, يأخذون بسنته, they were following his sunnah, his way of life, but also ويقتدون بأمري, but also they were ready to obey his commands. Before I continue, sometimes we have this perception that when Imam comes, mashallah, now we have Imam, everything is okay. Everything is not going to be okay unless you volunteer to be Imam Hawariyun and Ashab. Imam cannot work alone. It is a teamwork from the time of Anbiya. From the time of Anbiya, and that is why even Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had Ashab radiallahu anhum wa ardhan. Understand that Imam is only one person. He cannot do that much. But it is Sahaba who migrated to Habasha for the first time and second time. It is Sahabi who went to Yemen, Mu'adh ibn Jabal, Rasul is in Medina. It is Sahaba who was sent as ambassadors and envoys to Medina, minhum Mus'ab ibn Umayy, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, participated in serving the deen of Allah. At the same time, he had what is called Saraya expeditions. He was sending Sahaba who were ready to advance the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't sit back and say, what is this Imam doing? You want to fix that on the member today. Ask yourself, how am I helping this Imam to advance the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent a messenger, this messenger had Hawariyun and Ashab. What they did, they followed his sunnah, but also they obeyed his commands. Now the second part of hadith, ثم إنها تخلف من بعدهم خلوف. Then after these prophets, عليهم الصلاة والسلام, and after this Sahaba and Hawariyun succeeded them, successes, succeeded them another generation. How did they behave? يقولون ما لا يفعلون. They say what they don't do, which is very common in many communities. Very common in many Muslim communities. Talking, 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 but you do not do. You may have thousands of ideas, but Allah, you will never do it. Many people have ideas. Many people in the community. But you find that they don't do them. But also, وَيَفَعَلُونَ مَا لَا يُمَرُونَ. If they were to do, they also do what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Rasul never instructed them to do. They are contradicting deen. Talking is not going to help us. We rather talk small and act big. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala condemned people who just talk. He says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لِمَا تَقُولُونَ مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ. All you who believe, again nida min Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all you who believe, why do you say what you do not do? كَبُرَ مَقْتًا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَنْ تَقُولُ مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so angry. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so mad, if I were to use the street word on those who say, they talk, live service, can spend 8 hours just talking and talking, but they do not do. Islam does not go just with talking. Islam does not go only with talking. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. It is iman and good righteous deeds, doing, action. يَقُولُونَ مَا لَا يَفْعَلُونَ. That generation will say what they don't act upon. وَيَفْعَلُونَ مَا لَا يُؤْمَرُونَ. And if they act, they will do what Allah has not instructed them to do. Now Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, فَمَنْ جَاهَدَهُمْ بِيَدِهِ فَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ. Whosoever strives against those people with his hand, then he is a true believer. وَمَنْ جَاهَدَهُمْ بِلِسَانِهِ فَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ. Whosoever strives, make effort to stop such people with his tongue, he is a true believer. وَمَنْ جَاهَدَهُمْ بِقَلْبِهِ فَهُوَ مُؤْمِنُ. Whosoever make effort to stop them even by hating such habit, then he is a true believer. وَلَيْسَ وَرَاءَ ذَلِكَ مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ حَبَّةُ خَرْدَلٍ. And there is nothing beyond that equivalent to a mustard seed of iman. Respected brothers, in every community there are four types of people. I mentioned that in the past, in this masjid, four types of people. You need to make a choice today. Where do you belong? Sisters, make a choice today. Young girls, make a choice today. Elders, make a choice today. And youths, make a choice today. Where do you belong? In which category do you belong in our community here? The first category are doers. Doers, they do. Yani they love khayr, they do. They understood many ayat. Fastabiqul khayrat. They know that they have to compete. They know that they have to hasten in doing good. They do. But they are very few. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَلِيلٌ مِنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورُ. Anything to do with good, there are only few people who want to act, who want to do it. Many people have excuses. I'm busy, I'm this. So in every community, there are these few people who do things. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us chance. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us to be among the doers. Allah loves doers. Allah loves doers. The second group are those who loves doing good and they support it, even though they are not in the scene or a place where good things are implemented. They will support it. They wish that if udhur, if excuse is lifted, they would have been there. They were there in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sincerely they were there. But also there is opposite. Who came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with excuses? To the extent that they say, inna buyutana awra. Ah, they came with a lot of excuses. When it comes to soccer, when it comes to dunya issues, when it comes to business, they are number one at the door. But subhanAllah, when it comes to serving the need of Allah, so the second group are those who loves. They will support and they will spread good news about a good thing that happens in the community. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us to be amongst them. Number three are those who don't even know what is happening in the community. Because they don't want to know. Yeah, these ones are amwat ghayr ahya. They're already dead. Yeah, one of the scholars says, matan nas wa baqiya nas. Ha! This is a person who is very insensitive. Yeah, everything is okay with him. You ask him, what is happening in the masjid? He says, I don't even know. Okay, who is the imam? I don't know. What is your connection with the masjid? He says, I do pass there sometimes on Eid al-Fitr, at least once a year. Or sometimes at Juma, I come late. Yani, he doesn't want to know what is happening. And one of the reasons is that he has already accomplished and achieved and obtained American dream. What worries him? I have a good house, I have a good car, I have a wife, I have kids. Look at my life, mashallah. But now meet him outside and see how big talker he is. That condition is very bad, brothers. That condition is very bad. And I will give khutbah in future regarding that. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used hudhud to give da'wah, to change the whole nation. Which means that a bird can be better than a human being who decides not to be concerned. He is not concerned about the affairs of ummah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not make us to be amongst them. Category number three. Category number four. I say, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. This is a person, he's called self-appointed critic of the advancement and development of Islamic community. He will criticize everything that happens in the masjid, criticize everything that happens in the community. Yani, inda huda tura. He has PhD in criticizing from his own university. Nothing makes him happy. When he comes to the masjid from there, look at this. When he goes to place of wudu, look at this. When he comes to this, yani his life is laum and lawama. He criticizes everything. Most of us are there. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not make us to be amongst them. Ahbab Rasulullah. The Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Ummah that is meant to invite to khayr. It is the Ummah that is meant, that is established by Allah to encourage good. It is the Ummah that is meant to forbid evil. It is only through that that we will succeed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Ali Imran, وَلْتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةً. Let there be amongst you a band, a group. Don't you want to be amongst them? Don't you want to be amongst them? يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ. This group should be inviting people to all that which is good, all that has masalih for the community. They will be encouraging people. They are ambassadors of La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Don't you want to be amongst them? يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. But at the same time, they forbid evil. يعني يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. They will encourage everything which is good, but also they will discourage everything which is evil. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, those are the successful. So, I want to conclude with this hadith before I give you the thought of the day. There is hadith narrated by Hudhayfah ibn Yaman, and it is collected by Imam al-Tirmidhi radiallahu anhu. Hudhayfah says, أَنَّ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ قَالَ وَالَّذِي نَفْسِ بِيَدِهِ. By him, in whose hand my soul is, my life is, by Allah, لَتَأْمُرَنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. As a community, you will invest, you will make effort to encourage what is good. وَلَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. As a community, as ummah, you will forbid the evil. If you do not do that, if you neglect that, if you take it for granted, أَوْلَا يُشِكَلْنَ اللَّهَ أَنْ يَبْعَثَ عَلَيْكُمْ إِقَابًا مِنْهُ. Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala soon will bring his punishment upon you. ثُمَّ تَدْعُونَهُ. Then you will make all types of dua. Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah. What will happen? فَلَا يُسْتَجَابُ لَكُمْ. Your dua will not be accepted because you have not accomplished or filled, you have not fulfilled the condition of istijab. Having established this, Allah will ask you about many things. In this hadith, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when you stand in front of Allah, Allah will ask you about four questions. And عُمْرِكَ فِي مَثْنَى. How did you spend your age? In what? 60-50 years, in what did you spend it? Any youth is here, any young man, do not say that it's my time to enjoy. When I grow old, inshallah, I'm gonna be in the masjid and I'm gonna participate in advancing Islam. La. وَعَنْ شَبَابِكَ فِي مَا أَبْلَهِ. Even your youth, your teenage, Allah will ask you, how did you spend it to advance, to contribute in his cause? Also, وَعَنْ مَالِكَ مِنْ أَيْنَ اكْتَسَبْتَهُ وَفِي مَا أَنْفَقْتَ. The wealth that you are earning and acquiring, it has to be from halal source. It's not going to help you. You earn from haram, and then you say, I want to contribute to the masjid. You are playing with Allah. And you cannot play with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I know this is a little bit hard for some people. I have to say it. Allah will ask you, how did you acquire your wealth and how did you spend it? Spending in building a masjid or going for hajj does not justify it to be halal. And lastly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask you about what? Your knowledge that he gave you. Whether it is Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, whether it is A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-Rajim, whether it is one ayah, since Rasul said, بَلِّهُ عَنِّي وَلَوْ آيَةٌ. Allah will ask you about your knowledge. How did you spend it? وَخَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَ. If you want to be the best, learn one ayah and teach it. Ahbab, conclusion is this. I was here sharing my vision with Masjid Abu Bakr or Colorado Muslim Society, almost for 1 hour and 30 minutes. I'm back today as your imam. You have accepted me, you have entrusted me to stand here. It's not me. Some of you may have more knowledge than me. But I want to assure you that وَلَسْتُ بِخَيْرِكُمْ I'm not better than none of you. فَإِنْ رَأَيْتُمُونِي عَلَى الْحَقِّ فَأَعِينُونِ If you see me following the right path, don't give me tough time. Some people have a habit of giving imams tough time. Don't do that. Don't waste your time. Help me when I'm right. وَإِنْ رَأَيْتُمُونِي عَلَى شَرْ But also when you see me going a little bit off track, come with respect, come with respect. Don't shame me in front of people. Come, pull me aside and correct me, inshallah, because when you correct me, you are correcting the ummah. Obey me, ati'uni ma ata'tu Allah fikum. Obey me as long as I obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no dictatorship. When I'm wrong, when I disobey Allah, you should not obey. Four things that I have. The whole week I've been observing, I spoke to all levels of people in the community. Those who I could speak to. I received good advices, I received. And some people also were a little bit negative about so and so is bad. I want to tell you that all of you are good to me. Your past, I was not part of it. We have to open a new page as a family. I have come up with this. This is my da'wah, programs and activities connected to Imam's office. Anyone who is sincere and objective will find a place to help, support, and advance the deen of Allah. Anyone who is not sincere will never find nothing in this. 42 to 44 points. Please take it home, read it. Many communities say we are not consulted. I'm consulting. I need your inputs. Take it home, read it. Brothers and sisters, take it. It is being distributed. If you don't have a copy, follow us later on. Next week we'll produce. This is my manifesto. This is my progress. Please help me with ideas and inputs. Do not talk to me against people. Do not come to me telling me so and so is bad. Watch out of those and that. I will not listen to you. My voice is a little bit higher. I'm a member, but I'm not a fighter. So if you come with so and so is bad, and so and so is this, and they did this and that, I will walk and do not consider that to be rude. I love all of you. You are my brothers and your family. Unless you wanna find sulh when you talk to me about somebody and you will allow me to call him in your presence. But do not tell me, Rasul say do not tell me against people. فَإِنِّي أُحِبُّ أَنْ أَخْرُجَ إِلَى النَّاسِ وَأَنَا سَلِيمُ الصَّدْرِ I wanna meet with each one of you from kids to elders when my heart is clean with everybody. If you have religious issues, make an appointment with me in the office or catch me. But if you have other personal issues, please, you can meet me outside. The second point is member, microphone, and mihrab. We need to establish discipline. For anyone to use this microphone, or stand on the member, or here, I think we have an imam now. This is connected to imam's office. Please seek permission. Inshallah, let us not quarrel on this to make adhan and iqama announcement. I believe in structure. I believe in order, organizational structure. Please let us communicate before somebody leads salah. Let us communicate before somebody stands on the minbar or before somebody holds the mic. Few things that will help us. We have to do shura with one another. We need to consult. I will be consulting you. Consult me, inshallah, in general issues. Allah says, وَأَمْرُهُمْ شُورَى بَيْنَهُمْ Surah to Shura. Secondly, I believe in cooperation. الله سبحانه وتعالى سيد وتعاون على البر والتقوى ولا تعاون على الإثم والعدوان. We have to help one another in righteousness and piety and not the opposite. Another important point is we may have some issues in every community, but once leaders are elected, let us respect that until another election comes. And if there are issues, let us not raise our voices in the masjid. We raise our voice, we insult one another, we quarrel with no solution. Where is the concept of hiwar between us Muslims? Dialogue, talking, presenting your point. So inshallah we have Majlis Shura, but we also have executive board or body, which is administrative and managerial. We have president now at the center and we have imam. I believe that we can obey the authority as long as we obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And lastly, discipline, discipline, discipline and respect in the masjid, in our community, will really help us. Any program that was being conducted at the center, this is meant to unify our programs, but also I will supervise every religious program in the masjid. This program is activities. Anyone who wants to be in charge can come forward, and also anyone who wants to be a subcommittee of implementation come forward. It is high time that all our programs are unified and run under Imam's office. Anyone who wants to teach, anyone who wants to give a talk, anyone choose one of these, come and have a meeting with me. I will see what is your aqidah, what books are you using, and I'm also afraid for anybody coming to brainwash some people in the masjid, especially youths. I will not be responsible, you will be. I have to supervise, I have to screen, and anyone who wants to bring any book in the masjid, whether tafsir or hadith or seerah, make sure that you bring it through Imam's office before we put it anywhere in the masjid. Jazakumullah khair. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unite our hearts. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم ارض عن جميع صحابة رسول الله أجمعين وللصدق ومحبة ومودة، خصوصا منهم أبي بكر الصديق وعمر بن الخطاب وعثمان بن عفان وعلي بن أبي طالب. اللهم ارض عن بقية صحابة رسول الله أجمعين. اللهم ألف بين قلوبنا وأهدنا سبل السلام، نجنا من الظلمات إلى النور. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقوى، زكها أنت خير من زكاها، إنك أنت وليها ومولاها. اللهم الطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير، هون علينا كل عسير، إنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان، ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا، ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. رب يسر لنا ولا تعسر، وتمم بالخير وبك نستعين. اللهم انصرنا على أعدائنا في كل مكان. اللهم ارحم اخواننا في سوريا وفي ليبيا وفي افريقيا وفي اسيا وفي امريكا. اللهم ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الاخره حسنه وقنا عذاب النار. والحمد لله رب العالمين. واقم الصلاه وانتم موقنون بالاجابه.